Sin might be the way that brought you from heaven.
Certainly that's a strong piece of our condition. Certainly everybody's a sinner, me included. So, something got to be wrong with that.
Could somebody who doesn't know Jesus get to heaven? Yes?
It's all about being Catholic, right? If you've got an envelope number, you're going to heaven, right? Be yourself. You don't want to be a role for yourself. Do you really believe that in the people you love and care about? Do you know people who maybe don't go to church?
Yes.
Are they good people or bad? How would you feel if someone you love wasn't in heaven? Is that the God you believe in? A God who picks and chooses? A God who sticks labels on people? Congratulations, you got the right label. Oh, sorry. What do you think? Be honest with me, because we've got just a few. Yes, is that church teaching or is that not church teaching? Is he making that up or is that what the Catholic Church says? And the same thing, someone who's lived a good life, not a perfect life, but they really in their heart of hearts try to do the right things for the right reasons. Could that person face God and get to heaven? Yeah? Is that because you say so or because the church says so? Think. Raise your hand if you think that's church teaching. Now everybody raise your hand. Because that's exactly what the church says. You believe in a God who is all good and all merciful. Who else? Is there anybody else in the whole of creation who's all good and all merciful? No. Only God could sort out one human life. You're a really complicated person. I don't even know you. But you are, and so am I, and so are you. Only God, even people can't figure out their own lives completely. Don't you get confused sometimes? I surely do. Only a good and merciful and a just and a fair God could ever hope to figure out what your life really means. Total it all up in a final sum. So, yeah, you're exactly right. You're exactly right. But, are you entirely on your own? Or does God give you some help to find a good life? What kind of help does God give you to find a good life? Fortune cookies? What does God give you to find a good life? Name one of them. Where did you start? Who were the first people you met? Hey, your parents! Certainly your values began with them, didn't they? What were the values that your parents gave you? Catholic, Christian values. For the most part, huh? Many of you are from Catholic families, at least one parent's Catholic, huh? The values you got are the values you've been given, and then you built on them. Where did that come from? Where did all these Christian values and Catholic values come from? Who did they start with? Who brought them to us? Who preached in Galilee? First, the guy you just heard about, his name was Fred the Baptist. No, it wasn't Fred. What was his name? John the Baptist. He stood up and said, things are changing. Things are going to be different. Things are going to be different today, now.
here in your life. It's changing today. And it's changing because the one who's coming and the one who came is Jesus. Now, Jesus revealed for you a way to life that leads directly to God. All right, you want to take Liberty Road into town? Go ahead. It'd be quicker on 70, wouldn't it? And don't go Friday evening because it's only 5:15 to 7. Know the right way to go, know when to go, know how to get there. That's what Christ gave you. Gave you the best GPS in the world. A direct beacon to God. Does everybody know that? Did some people have more trouble than others? I don't know. Is it just about labels? Are there Catholics who don't get it? Granted, it's a great help to have Jesus fully revealed. But could there be some pretty good Lutherans? Or how about the Baptist next door? How about somebody in your own family whose faith is really strong? Why are you here? Who said to you this is a good place to be? Who taught you this is a good place to be? If this is a place you live, this is a place you belong. And one day, when you have kids, you'll want to live in a place like this. They can choose. How free are you? You choose God? Or has God chosen you? Which is it? I mean, Troy, I know you got the answer, but I want to talk to some of these other guys because I don't know some of these guys. Did you choose God or did God choose you? That's exactly correct. You should be up here. You got it. That's all I came to say today. You chose God, and God chose you. And the best vantage point we have, the best we know about, is the way that Jesus gave us, and the truest sense of what Jesus gave us lives in this church. Are there other things that are true? Sure there are. Are there great religions and great people in those religions? Surely there are. Do the Yankees win every World Series? No. They win a lot of them. I think that's what's true of everything. We have some truths that are real, some things we believe that work, that have worked for 2,000 years because we didn't make them up. Christ gave them to us. And by following what Christ gave us, we're closest. Okay. Are you shaking your head no yet?
No. Thank you.
No. All right. Stump the priest now. Was this mobile patio? Does this make sense? How do you answer someone who says to you, well, you're really not going to heaven because you haven't accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior? What's the answer to that? Has anybody ever said anything like that to you? You don't belong to my church, you're not going to heaven. How do you answer? I'm curious, because I don't know how to answer that sometimes. It depends on the person. How do you answer? Would you be comfortable with such a question? There are people who believe in their faith so strongly that it excludes you. We believe in our faith so strongly that it excludes others. I can tell you, for somebody who worked in a hospital for a lot of years, when people are really sick, this would be a huge problem. If someone believes that unless we do A, B, C, and D, we're not going to heaven. And I want my husband there. How about when you fall in love and you want to get married? And your beliefs differ. Does it make a difference? Do you think so? Have any of you grown up in families where there are different beliefs in different parts of the family? I sure do. I'm telling you, what you believe has to stand. got to be real for you. It's got to be your choice. Exactly right. God has already chosen you. My question to you is, have you chosen God? And how? I'm glad to talk to you. And I'm not going to trouble you with any more questions. Anything you guys want to say or ask?